Hello, my name is Emily Browne and I am one of the course directors here at Staffordshire University, and I'm just going to talk to you a little bit about what happens in one of our skills labs. So as part of your course, 50% of your training is out in practice, working in the hospitals, in the community, in one of the many different areas that you might be assigned to as part of your practice. And the other 50% is in university, where we teach you all of those key skills that you need to be a nurse. Some of that's going to be theory, about 50% of that is going to be theory, and then 50% is going to be practical, hands-on experience, learning all those things you need to be able to do as a nurse. So you'll come to one of our skills rooms like this, and there'll be various different tasks that we train you on. And at first, we'll start you off nice and slowly, teach you some of those basic skills, and as you develop, as you grow with that training, we'll integrate that into simulation, where we'll have mannequins or live patients that you will treat and care for within the safe environment of the school. And I don't know if you can hear in the background, but we have actually got major building works going on outside the window now while we build our multi-million pound simulation centre that will be ready and open for business in October 2021. And that's where you'll be taking part in some of that simulation activity. But just to give you a bit of a whistle-stop tour of some of the things that we do in a skills lab, one of the key things that we can do to find out what's going on with a patient is test their urine. So you're going to come along to the skills lab, and you might be faced with a skills station such as this. We've got some information on procedures and how we go about doing that, and then the all important samples. As you can see, these are various different hues that we're going to look at, and we will teach you how to look at that urine, how to investigate it, and to potentially find out what's going on with your patient, which will lead to the different types of treatment that they may need to have. And we'll then give you that information around how we're treating them and the medications and things that we may choose to use. We've also got some of our basic observational equipment. So one of the things you'll learn to do is take a blood pressure. You'll learn how to use a stethoscope to auscultate or listen to somebody's chest, and you'll also use that in the requirement of a patient's blood pressure. A key piece of nursing equipment is something called a dynamat, and on this it looks a bit spangly, loads of cables and cords and things like that. But this can give you the basic observations of a patient, so their blood pressure, so that we know what's going on with that. That could be making them feel faint, that could be giving them headaches, it could be all sorts of different things. That blood pressure can give us a lot of information. We can do that on the machine automatically or manually. We can also use a oxygen saturation probe. This goes onto somebody's finger. This tells you what their oxygen saturation is, so the level of oxygen in their blood, and it can also look at their heart rate. Other devices that we'll use, such as thermometers and different things like that, and we're going to teach you how to use all of them appropriately. And what's really important is we're going to teach you what those numbers mean and how that affects the patient. But it all comes in stages as we teach it to you. One of the key things about nursing is looking and listening. So we look at our patient, we see what's going on with them, we can see what their colour's like. Have they gone slightly blue? Are they sweaty? Are they clammy? All of those different things. And listen, what are they telling me? What are they saying to me about how they feel? And these are all skills that we're going to develop through skill stations like this, and then through simulation where we look at real patients. One of the things that all nurses feel is quite an exciting skill to learn is venipuncture and cannulation. And this is one of the skills that is included in our curriculum. It's not the most important nursing skill, it's just one of the skills that we do along the way. But venipuncture and cannulation is done. We have these different task train arms. This is one of the ones that we don't do on live patients in the skills lab. So we replicate that here. You can practice it, get your skill honed and correct, practice it through simulation, and then go out into practice and deliver that to patients within the community. And I've got with me here today, I've got Kairen, who is one of our nursing lecturers, who you will meet when you start your journey of nursing here at Staffordshire University. And Kairen, just tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hello, my name's Kairen. I've been nursing a very long time, far too long to let you know about. But I started in accident and emergency, and then I've spent the last 27 years as a practice nurse working within a doctor's surgery. I absolutely love teaching and nursing, and this has always been like something that I've always wanted to do. So this morning, when I was teaching my trainee nurses, it was such a pleasure to be able to teach them. And as Emily says, you come in and we teach you tasks. But because it's like thinking, linking theory to practice, all the things that you're learning in college about consent, about when to breach confidentiality, about privacy, dignity, British values, we all bring them those together and we teach those within the classroom. So when I was teaching this morning, yes, I taught the clinical skill of taking venipuncture, but we also discussed when you shouldn't take venipuncture, you know, talking about dignity, when somebody might faint, making sure our patients are safe, and making sure our patients really understand what we're doing as well. So linking the theory to the practice is really, really important when you come. So there's a lot of underpinning procedures and knowledge and videos to watch before you actually get to do venipuncture within a lab. Skills is so predominant now within our nursing, and we really think that it's really good to be able to come and practice on different types of arms, so you can get a really good grounding for when you do actually try and see those patients in you know, when you're going to the clinical practice area. So we try and bring everything together really within this environment, so then you can go into clinical practice and be able to be confident, to know what you're doing, to link the theory to the practice, to link all to the guidelines and the government guidelines, and really bring everything together so you're confident in front of that patient and you can make that patient feel brilliant when you're looking after them. And that's what we like to do, is try and empower you with the skills and the knowledge and understanding to be able to go out there and be great nurses. We'd love you to come and train with us. I absolutely love nursing. I'll teach anybody from nursing, from healthcare assistants up to master's level, because we really treasure all our students here at Staffs Uni, and we'd love you to come and join us. So we look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you very much.
This is one of our simulation wards, and in this area you've got several different patients in beds awaiting you and your nursing skills to come and treat them. So this patient has got a cannula inserted. That may have been Kairen and her team who've already put that in. They're obviously got observations ongoing, and there may be things that you need to do for this patient, and it will be part of a real-time exercise where you carry out those tasks that you've learned in the skills lab on your actual patient. Nursing is a fantastic career. It can take you anywhere in the world. You learn something new every day, and every day is different, because making a difference to people's lives is a really privileged position to be in. And we hope that you would like to come and join us here at Staffordshire University and be the change and be the difference in the NHS of the future.